Hi, Trudy Beerman here of TrudyBeerman.com, host of Debt-Free Wealth Radio. Now, I made a huge life-changing decision this week. And actually, there's three parts to it. And I want to document it here just so that I remind myself of this decision. And maybe you guys might want to come along this journey with me. I surely hope I'll get some encouragement and some accountability out of this at the very least. So here are the decisions that I made. I decided that I was going to eat clean. I was going to go dairy-free and I was going to go gluten-free. Those are huge, challenging decisions. And I need to hold myself accountable to this because I believe it is really going to change my life for the better. Now, here is the thing. I'm almost 47 years old, and over the past years, I have done many things to lose weight. And very recently, I've been on a weight loss process, and I have been losing the weight. But this time around, I don't know if it's because I'm almost 47 years old, but I was more open to health information this time around. What do I mean by that? In the past, and I don't know about you, but a lot of times when we want weight loss, we're not so worried about the process. So I think that's why a lot of people are open to liposuction, to drugs, to starvation, to bulimia, whatever. The point is we want the weight loss and we're not really caring too much about the process that gets us there. So yeah, as long as the strategy works, we're good. So this time around though, I started to listen to a lady named Pele Chen, and also I read Tosca Rena, and they kept talking about clean eating and eating real food and all, you know, all this stuff. And I was like, what are they talking about? Because I, you know, I would have told anybody that I'm, you know, eating well, I'm healthy, I'm, you know, making good choices and surely eating more fruits and vegetables and going to the grocery and all that good stuff. But you know what? It's not the same as eating clean. It is not. So for example, this is a potato. This is potato chips. This is clean eating. This is not. And I'll go into this a little bit more. Now, can somebody lose weight eating potato chips? Absolutely. If you're one of those that's following the calories, fat, and all that stuff. But I'll go into that a little bit later. The point is that this time around, for my health, I just felt like I got off the highway and I'm taking the scenic route. I have no medical condition that I'm, you know, I've had no diagnosis. I just wanted to take better care of myself. And I thought I was doing that until I kept hearing about this clean eating. So clean eating is a new journey for me. It's a completely different pathway to just what we think is making healthy choices, because there's a lot of non-food foods out there. And I've made another video that kind of highlights that a little bit more. So clean eating. The second one was dairy free. Now, I thought that was going to be very hard because I love cheese. I love cereal. I love Italian food. And I was like, how the heck am I going to do without milk and cheese? But it's been actually probably the easiest of the three decisions. There are lots of options out there for to go dairy free. The third one, though, is going to be a really big challenge, going gluten-free. Now, if there's wheat in something, chances are there's gluten somewhere. But I love bread and I love pasta. And this is probably going to be the hardest one for me. But I've read, you know, Bill O'Reilly has lost weight and all he credits that to is getting off of wheat and, you know, going gluten-free. And it's not about trying to lose weight by going gluten-free. It's the fact that as I've done this research, it just seems like a lot of people are having digestive problems and it's related to gluten. And also the wheat that we get today has been so genetically modified over time, it no longer resembles the wheat that our ancestors ate. So I think that that is part of the whole chemical laboratory foods that we've been eating. And so that's why I made that decision. So three huge decisions, guys. Eating clean, going dairy-free, going gluten-free. I'm going to need your help with this. I know I'm going to be better off for it. And I'm going to document this process because it is huge. It is huge for me. You know, I'm almost 47. I've got 47 years of habits under my belt. So, and this is a new uncharted territory. I'm learning as I go. I certainly don't have the answers right now, but I'm going to document the process as I go, and I hope you'll join me. Thank you.